Without proper supplies, survival on a glacier would be nearly impossible. Nighttime temperatures will reach negative 30 degrees Fahrenheit, and there are virtually no available resources for making fire or shelter.
Cody, watch this, right here.
In these conditions, death by hypothermia is guaranteed within hours of sundown.
Hey, Cody, this thing's coming to an end. We're at the edge of it right now.
Yeah, but that's just a vast wasteland, man. That's like a frozen desert. It's not much better than where we're at right now, but at least it's lower.
Yeah, we can't stay here, though, obviously. There's nowhere to shelter.
Yeah, let's keep going down.
All right.
Having made it from the glacier to a barren area known as the Highlands, Joe and Cody now battle 50-mile-per-hour winds, stinging hail, and freezing rain.
This is bleak.
Cody, we have got to get down out of here and find shelter.
We'll start heading down.
I mean right now.
Finding shelter before nightfall is paramount to keeping their core body temperature from falling into the danger zone.
Ideally, we can get it out of the wind, away from the wind, but I don't know, because the low spot's right into the wind. Let's just get down.
Yeah.
The only thing that's keeping us going is that we keep moving to generate heat.
This place is bleak.
There's snow blowing in your face, your lips are going numb, you're starting to freeze. The hypothermia risk in a situation like this is very, very high, especially for Cody.
We have got to find shelter ASAP.
The man is here in shorts and socks in a frozen wasteland. If he goes down, I'm going with him because he knows I'm not going to leave him here.
There's a ledge up here.
Maybe we could do something here. I know the wind's blowing right into it.
No, this is a no-go.
Cody.
The wind is blowing directly into the rock, and it's on a ridge. We can't even think about being there. This is a no-go. We got to keep moving.
But dude, I'm concerned about you right now. I gotta tell you, I need to get you to some shelter, bro.
Really? Why is that?
We're in Norway right now.
Yeah?
It's freezing cold and you're in shorts.
I've gotta
worry about that.
Come on, Joe.
For real?
Cody is jeopardizing his safety and my safety because he chooses to wear shorts and socks in a winter survival situation. All he's doing is adding risk to a very risky situation.
You're shorts in Norway.
I teach winter survival. You don't. Let's keep moving.
If you don't find shelter down there, what are you going to do?
I'm wearing 3 pairs of wool socks. So my feet are very warm right now because I've trained for this and I know what I'm doing.
Joe, look at where you're proposing that we stay. Look at the wind.
You're compromising our mission.
You better pray you find a shelter.
But you're not going to make it out of here and I've got to carry you out.
My life is being compromised.
Joe, I know the difference between being dangerous and being uncomfortable. It's not a gimmick, it's not a joke. I've earned the right to do this for over 2 decades of doing what I do. Keep moving.
This is not the place or time to argue with your partner. He wants to keep moving. I can't stop him, so my only choice right now is to keep moving with him.
With 2 hours of daylight left, the journey to lower ground continues. Still with no suitable shelter area in sight and temperatures well below freezing, their only hope for staving off hypothermia lies in their ability to block the punishing winds and store metabolic heat from their bodies inside a shelter.
Let's follow this finger down, Cody.
Cold weather has a way of robbing the body of motivation, of calories, of literally the will to live. My thing is just to keep moving the body, generate metabolic heat, and to keep heading down.
Nighttime temperatures in the Norwegian highlands can sink to as low as 30 degrees below zero Fahrenheit.
Very bad. Stupidly bad.
Making death from hypothermia almost a guarantee if left unprotected by some form of shelter.
We've got about an hour of sunlight, Cody, and that's it.
Joe, there's trees down here now. As we cross another ridge, we do see some tree cover. It's the only cover we've seen, so we're gonna go for it.
Cody, check this out.
I see some junipers and a rock outcropping, and I'm saying to myself, this is it.
We're still in the wind a little bit, but I think we got very, very lucky finding this.
The wind's still blowing right into it, though.
Yeah, it is. But we've got stuff we can use.
I think we should stay right here and make the best of it. It's not a perfect situation, you know that.
I think the light decrees that we have to. We don't have enough light to do much else. This is the best thing we've come across, and we're losing light. We can't really advance forward anymore. So as much as I would like to turn the wind around and have it on the other side of this rock ledge, it's not gonna happen.
At least we've got some greenery here that we can put down on the ground for sure, and we can build some kind of shelter.
Yeah.
With this kind of wind, I seriously doubt a fire is gonna be in the equation.
First thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna clear out the snow. I'm gonna build a snow wall here. If you wanna get some juniper, definitely to sit on, I'd get it from those so we don't compromise this.
Yeah, and we'll get to work.
This is a team event. You may have disagreements, but at the end of the day, you've got to come together and work together. And Cody and I have come to terms that this is where we're going to shelter, so it's time to get to work.
This situation is very, very challenging, if nothing else but from the wind. We're going to try to use the snow from this area to help make this shelter location better than it is. Newly fallen snow is 90% air. So it's an awesome insulator. We both have a fire within us, 300 BTUs every hour, burned in metabolic heat just sitting there. So if we can create a windbreak and then deal with juniper for conduction on the ground, people would have a chance here.
So Cody, I've been in there already. I think if you just build it to the height that you have over there, you go in there and try it out and you tell me what you think.
I'll try it. I'll keep jacking this up.
I've got just a few more boughs and I'm just gonna line the inside on some little holes. But it's
I bring that pack in too as well, you know, anything to deal with conduction. And then we'll decide about the canvas later on.
I'm gonna use everything I have at our disposal, including the backpack and the rope, to get Cody and I's body off the ground. What I'd like to do is not tear this thing up as much as possible, obviously, so we can get out of here, but if we have to, we do.
The bunny should stay outside and then we'll see. We're debating whether to put the polk over the top. I think we're gonna pass on that. We don't want to jeopardize this wall. There's not a lot of light left. So we have a great conductive bed of this juniper. We also have the rope and the backpack and the blessed caribou hide, which will be over the top of us. And we'll trap the long wave radiation between our two bodies with the caribou hide and the backpack and whatever else.
Hey, Cody, all this stuff that's hanging down here, to be quite honest with you, is more of a pain in the butt than it's worth, but we can leave it if you want. Depending on how cold it gets here at night, you may or may not have to do some sissy squats and some exercises to stay warm. Hopefully that will not be the case.
It's a windbreak. I know just leave it for now.
Because what I'm seeing is our heads will be up that way, feet out this way, entrance right here.
Right, and that's kind of an impromptu door. If we lose time, we're losing light. So just leave it for now.
All right.
We'll get it out of there if we need to.
For someone to survive the night in a situation like this, what you don't want to have happen is for the weather to turn to crap. If it really starts to storm and the temperature drops 20 degrees, you're going to be in a state. You never want to lay directly on the ground due to conduction. It's going to suck the heat right out of your body. The ideal situation is to get your body about 3 inches off the ground. There's just a few holes. I've got the inside kind of matted.
I'm gonna take the powdered snow and actually throw it onto the wall itself so it not only clogs the gaps or the holes from stacking the blocks, but it actually cements because of the friction of the molecules of the snow going across each other called sintering. It makes the wall stronger, so it's less liable to tip over.
I was a little harsh on Cody earlier, but that man has got to understand where I came from. If you were to pull a stunt like coming to an environment like this in shorts and socks, you would not have even gone to the unit psychologist. You'd have been booted.
Man, we're tight as a tick in here.
So he needs to understand, I am not used to someone dressing the way he does, and that puts him and I at risk.
This is actually a lot warmer than I thought it would be.
Keep Bogart and the caribou hide, though.
But now we have found a shelter, luckily for him.